Charles has filled multiple sheds with paraphernalia, making him Jersey's best-known hoarder.
Sometimes, occasionally, swap things with other collectors, but that's about the limit of parting with anything.
Charles, hello.
Hello.
Nice to meet you.
Hello.
With seemingly endless salvage to search through, this could be another great opportunity for Drew to get his hands on yet more quirky items from the island.
Oh, yeah, now you're talking. Is this your workshop?
Yes, this is where I spend a lot of time repairing things, making things. We've got a few bits and pieces in here.
Just breathe it in. It's lovely. Oh, my word, look at this.
And more bits and pieces in there.
Wow. First impression is he's never thrown anything away. Ever. He's got the thing that was in the packing case and the packing case. People who don't throw stuff away are brilliant to buy from, but also difficult to buy from. So we'll see how we get along. I think we've got a lot to see, haven't we?
Yeah, let's go.
The clock, it's in the same style as the older Smith's clocks or the older simplex ones as well. Do you have any more clocks like that?
Not like that, no.
OK. Is that one for sale?
No.
OK.
After so many years stockpiling, Charles is clearly attached to his items. Drew will need to call on the very best of his negotiating skills to win him over.
I'm pretty good with hoarders. I've only ever been completely beaten by one once when I couldn't buy a single thing, and I tried every trick in the book. I usually get on with them because I'm sort of one chromosome away from doing it myself. Would you sell that?
Well, no, I don't think so, because that's something I could use on the house.
And a Fergie tractor,
there's a grey Fergie tractor.
Grey Fergie.
Got more tractors in here, but they're a bit buried, unfortunately.
Gosh. How many have you got?
I'm not sure. I see it now, but the jerry can.
Ah, it's a proper one.
It's left behind by the Germans.
Ah. That's where the nickname jerry cans, because the British Army used to pinch them. Because they were so much better. Because ours used to blow up and leak and you couldn't handle them properly.
Charles may be Jersey's premier hoarder, but he's met his match in Drew. He's not one to be put off the scent of salvage.
You just got to keep looking, haven't you, in this place?
There's a lot.
Oh, there's a tractor in there.
Yes, that's an International W14. That's pre-war.
There's a leather armchair underneath all this stuff.
You could sit in it and admire the other things.
Before I go pulling this thing out and having a look at it, is it for sale?
Possibly.
Possibly.
For a substantial fee.
What sort of money before? Because it's going to take a while to get this out.
I don't know.
Just throw me the chair over?
Yeah.
The chair's damaged, and Charles has something to confess.
There'll be a hole in the side of it. That was made by me when I was a child, about 6 years old.
Feet in there.
I heated up a penny in front of the fire and held it against the...
But you were popular, weren't
you? Yes, very. Yeah.
This leather armchair dates from the 1940s. It's very worn and has the hole that needs repairing. Once restored, it could be worth around £600.
When I first saw it, I thought, oh, that's going to be in terrible state. And it's not that bad, actually. It's got a rip in the top. There's another small tear underneath that side of the arm. Small tear in the back. That, restored, in your house, you're going to love it. It's got those square, flat, rigged arms. They're going to sell the chair, basically, that form on the top of the arm. I just need to buy it as cheaply as possible. In this state, would £100 buy it?
I think you might be able to go a bit more. And it's got all that dust to go with it.
Is that free?
No, we'll be paying for that as well.
OK. Final bid, 140.
Fine, yes, let's go on that. Fine, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
150 if it's out there when I pick it up.
Jeff's yard is full of cars and vans, but some of them have been there so long, identifying them is impossible. This is clearly not going to be straightforward for Drew.
Some Studebakers.
Oh, my God, yeah.
Been there a couple of years. There's something Fader collected years ago. He's always liked things like that.
Well, there's two in there, is there?
There is, yeah. There's one behind as well.
Blimey, they've been there a while, haven't they?
The American classic can be worth as much as £12,000 if fully restored. This one is worth a bit less.
Now I'm going to take them, Jules. Get them on the van.
Yeah, load them up.
I'll get a shovel. Take them out.
There's a werewolf next door.
Oh, that's fine.
He won't come out till after dark, if you're right.
We'll go around the other side. There's just so much stuff here, and it's been here an awful long time.
Drew thinks he's spotted a gem, an early 20th century wrought iron gate.
Is there another gate to go with this, Jeff? It's just the one of these gates here.
Do you know where there's another one?
Where the other one is?
No, I think it must be just that one, I think.
That's a shame.
But half of it is missing, and he moves on. Even Drew is struggling, but then his salvage hunter instinct kicks in, and he spots something that could potentially make this trip worthwhile.
It's all his staddle stone.
These mushroom-shaped stones probably date from the 18th century and were used to elevate granaries and hay racks away from the ground to protect them from vermin. Today, they're very desirable ornaments, and garden designers will pay up to £350 apiece.
There's how many here? One, two.
Drew often finds one or two staddle stones, but Jeff seems to have a large number. This could be a great find.
Quite a few. How many is there? It's about seven now, is there?
Yeah, it must be about seven or eight.
These are all for sale, are they?
Yeah, he's sold a few of them, yeah.
Oh, great.
But if Drew wants them, he'll have to deal with Mr. Tite Sr.
Is this the boss?
That's my father, yeah.
Hello there. Hi, Mr. Tite. Drew.
Tite the name and Tite the nature.
Yeah. I like the staddle stones you've got. There's quite a few. I think there's probably 12 altogether.
Yeah.
And 10 that I can use.
Yeah.
I think they've got tops and aren't damaged on the bases.
About £225 apiece.
Really?
Yeah, we've got to start up somewhere.
We've got to start somewhere, yeah. Let's start really high.
Take you not too much off.
I want to buy all of them, so I need to get the price down as low as I can. What if I said I was going to take 10? Mm. What could you do if I took a big lump of them, a lot of them?
10.
I'd be after quite a discount, to be honest.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Couple grand.
I was hoping to buy them and buy all of them, everything, for £150 each, which would be £1,500.
Yeah.
I'll pull out as many as I can. If I find more, I'll pay you the same for more of them. Because some are good. Some I'm going to make good money on.
Yeah.
And some aren't so good. Mm. Some have got good tops and some have got no tops at all or a mismatched top. So it would be that. Mm. That sort of money. What do you reckon?
£175 apiece.
About £175 apiece. Mm. OK, I'll dig out as many as I can.
Okay.
Good deal. Enjoy that. That's good.
Finally, Drew has a good deal, but old Mr. Tite has a final surprise to let Drew know who's boss.
Cash.
Cash?
Yeah.
I'll see what I can do.